One of the figures that both Islam and Christianity share in common is John the Baptist. And there's a connection between John the Baptist and Hussein in that they were both martyred by tyrants, both beheaded, in fact. The sources for John the Baptist include the Gospels as well as a first century historian, Josephus. And the question is what was John the Baptist doing that got him such in trouble with Herod, the king at the time? And according to the Gospel stories, Herod had taken his brother's wife as his own wife. And John the Baptist, who was a person of righteousness and upstanding and morality, criticized Herod for doing that. He went against calling the king out on his bad behavior. And so the story is that the king arrested him, and his daughter ended up doing a dance for him one day, and Herod, in his kind of reverie, offered her, what would you like? I'll give you anything, half the kingdom. And the daughter, in the line of his of Herod's wife, said, I want the head of John the Baptist on a platter. And so the story is that Herod had John the Baptist beheaded. But that is not really perhaps the whole historical story. The thing is that John the Baptist was baptizing people. That is, he was giving them a baptism, a ritual of purification, so that they would be pure before God. And he was gathering quite a following. Herod was concerned, according to Josephus, that John the Baptist was actually making a movement, and he could be a political enemy. And so that is the case in which Herod had John the Baptist arrested and imprisoned. So there's two different narratives about that, one from Josephus and one from the Gospels. But in either case, John the Baptist was a person of high moral standing. And he was a person who called the king out on his misdeeds, and he was a person who spoke truth to power, much like Hussein. Now, Hussein also was concerned about the purity of his grandfather's faith, and that the leadership of his grandfather, the Prophet Muhammed, peace be upon him, would not be taken over by a person of bad character. And Yazid was just that person. He was an individual who was considered by Hussein to be corrupt and not worthy to carry on the leadership of Islam. And so when Yazid wanted Hussein politically to be on his team, so to speak, Hussein refused to do that, even at the threat of his own life and the threat of his family's life. And even when the odds were 72 to 30,000, Yazid and his army surrounded Hussein. But Hussein would not cave in, and he stood up for what he felt was right, and he knew that his martyrdom would ultimately, for future generations, be able to save Islam and be a sign of what the power of right versus might. And so Hussein, like John the Baptist, were both characters of high moral quality and resisted tyrants.
I'm a Christian pastor, but because of my encounter with Imam Hussein alayhi salam, I have received a renewed faith in the work of Jesus and Hussein, peace be upon them both, for justice and truth. Jesus and Hussein are brothers. They are one. If the human race is going to survive, we all must be one.